Okay, hello everybody, it is Super Stupidy, back with some more Takua 64. This episode, we're back in the jungles of Le-Wahi, finding the five crystals. So, a few things. We could go back up that way, back into Area 3. I don't know what else to call it. Call it Area 3. I don't know what to tell you. Anyway, or we could go this way into Area 2. And, because they make a triangle, so. So that's pretty cool, right? Right? The three areas that create the triangle, and they all connect to each other. Anyway, we're going into the ruins here. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, there's another Swamp Strider guy here. Hi, buddy. How's it going? You're very handsome. Oh! Okay, so, there are a couple ways up. You could either jump up there and make your way up there, or you could go across this pond if you wanted, this swampy pond, and you could jump off of this wall here to climb this platform. This is the intended way, but I realize after having created it, that this way is more complicated, I guess, than doing the shortcut way, which is over there. I don't know, maybe. Maybe it is. I guess the wall jump kind of throws beginners. Okay, look at this snake, bog snake guy. He's pretty cool. I really like the color scheme I chose for this model. Turned out pretty nicely, I like it. Yeah, look out. Anyway, we're doing find the five crystals. So, we're back in the room with the big trees. And we're gonna start by collecting crystals. So, at various areas in this level, you might notice all these little Lego ant guys crawling around, and they're going to help us find the crystals. They're gonna help guide us to the crystals. So, we're gonna have to find the five areas with all the ants and stuff. So let's go this way to 2 and 3. Let's go this way to 2 and 3. Yeah. There's one right in here in this tree, right in the stump of this tree. All right, now we go this way, and we're going to go this way, down this way. Whoa, this cliffside. Okay, that's 3. Now we're gonna go to 4 and 5. This is a pretty easy level. I feel like the ants really make this one not a big deal. If the ants weren't here, this would be a seriously painful level. And there's already a few mean hiding spots in this level. So I feel like that would have definitely been completely unnecessary to make the five crystals level really annoying. Okay, anyway, wah! Boop. Let's go this way. Follow the ants. Yes, follow the ants. Boom, boom. The five crystals have been collected. Now, we can collect a Toa Stone. Bing! Missed. You missed, you dumb idiot. Give it. Alright, five crystals is complete. Let's jump back in. What do we got now? Hiding in a tree trunk. Okay, I did mention there was a mean hiding spot in this level, and this is the meanest. This is probably the meanest. Should I go up this way? I'm not gonna go up that way. That way sucks. I wanna see from this angle. Womp, womp, womp. Can I just jump up through this? Like so? That'll work. Bah! Bah! Okay, alright, let's go, anyway, so, the secret is not in here, the hidden in the tree trunk is not in here, I actually had to change the name of this one. It was called, like, hidden in the tree or something like that, and that was kind of stupid. That was probably even more vague than it should have been. I feel like the tree trunk definitely made it a little bit more fair. Okay, anyway, can we see it from here? Nope, it won't be from here. Let's go to where we summoned the five crystals. I want to see if we can see it from there. Whoop-a-pa, beep-beep-beep. So, I have a good story about this one. Okay, anyway, can we see it? Yes, we can see it. Nice. Okay, anyway, I kind of spoiled its location, but, so it is possible to see from the center, which is cool. It's possible to see from here. Anyway, the funny story involves the fact that it was originally more obscure and more hidden. And I had a friend of mine play testing this. Doing a little play testing. I didn't get a lot of play testing for the game. Mostly it was just me. But I did occasionally ask a few friends to try it out and make sure there weren't any really obvious problems with it. And I had to kind of direct my friend to find this one because it was kind of at the end of the session and we were wrapping it up and I wanted to see what he thought of this one in particular. So it's visible from here, which is where you're supposed to jump from, but I actually want to climb the tree a little bit higher. I want to see, because originally, let me point it out, originally, this branch that's here was actually moved over here, and it was, like, directly above here, and the purpose of it was to completely obscure the entrance from the branches above. So it was obscured from there. That light stone wasn't there, so there wasn't any movement or contrast to direct your eye to it. It was more obviously covered up because I think that moss was further down as well. It was like covering, obscuring the entrance a bit as well. Anyway, this was like probably the meanest hiding spot in the game. And I told him, I said, this one was, after I showed it to him, I said, this one was inspired by that area in Metroid Prime. And I just started smiling because I already knew how he was going to react to that. And he goes, the one you need the x-ray visor for? I said, yeah, the one you need the x-ray visor for. So anyway, that secret was inspired by an area in Metroid Prime that you need to be able to see through walls to find, so that's the joke. That's the funny part about it. Anyway, so that's that. It's a little bit easier to find. He demanded that I changed it, and I told him I wouldn't, and then I changed it. So anyway, down the slippery moss, let's hit this one. This is probably the hardest level of the level. This is the hardest stone of the level, probably, for a few reasons. First of all, it's hard to reach the slide. Second of all, the slide is kind of difficult, just because it requires, like, a different skill set from normal platforming, so it's kind of like learning a new game. But I do like it. I do like this slide. Anyway, bop, get crushed. So, should I do the intended way? Should I go up the intended way? Sure. I'll go up the intended way. So the intended way to get up here, bah, 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 is to climb up this here and jump, ba da da. You can't jump. Okay, we'll climb up here, ba 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 ba, get over here, and then you can ja-ja. Right up here, and then from here you can move on. But I kept falling off of this because it was kind of a tough challenge, and so I found that you could actually jump off of this wall. It didn't look like that before, but I found that you could jump off of that wall to get up here, and then I was like, hey, I'll just stick, getting up the required way is not fun, so I'll just make it more obvious that it's wall jumpable. So I put a wall jump texture on there, and called it a day. And now you can wall jump up there, and it makes it a little bit less tedious than having to go the long way, the long intended way. Anyway, so I just wall jump up there. You can see that I kind of pointed out various wall jumping areas with textures that all kind of look like this, or like that one. Mostly they look like that one because it's a little more inconspicuous than these ones, which are much more obvious. So you'll find a bunch of areas in the game that kind of point out wall jumps. Like that. Anyway, so here we are, down the slippery moss. This is the area. and we're gonna be sliding down. So, there are a couple ways. If you go straight, you can go the big, long way around. Wee. But I'm gonna slide off here because I wanna show the short way. I wanna show the short way, and my favorite way. There's a short way, and it's faster than going the long way around. So I always take the cool person way. This way. I suck. No! The levels are going to be getting a little harder from here, so I probably won't be completing every level with minimal deaths as I have been so far. Anyway, this is my preferred route, is to make that jump instead. It's more fun. It's more fun and it takes less time as long as you nail it. Anyway, sliding down this room, I like this room with the Miru spilling out, the Miru's pouring water all over the place. They're pretty cool. I like them. Okay, anyway. Let's jump up a da. I fell in the swamp. Stupid. Okay. Anyway, so that's the first half of this slide. Now we just gotta tackle the second half, which is a little bit less dangerous. But also, the nerves might get to you. Whee! So I'm gonna go this way, and I'm gonna jump into this. And then we're gonna go this way, and we're gonna switch tracks again. Alright, we did it! So, I fall into this area. So I guess I'll just jump up here. No, it wasn't enough. Ow, I'm gonna crunch. I didn't want to be up here. It sucks up here. No, I fell. No, I'm bad at the game. Fine, I'll do it this way. Never mind, I'm bad at that too. Let's do this. Okay. Pretty sure you can actually make the Toa Stone from the slide if you don't drop down like I did. You can use the momentum to carry you straight into the... I don't know if you can actually reach the stone itself or if you can only reach the platform the stone is on, but either way, you can get a lot closer to it. Okay, it's time to stop playing around. That's enough playing around. Let's actually get it for real. Pop. Bing. Okay, slippery moss. Anyway, we only have the secret one left. So, that's good. Down the slippery moss. So I guess we'll get the last one and then we'll go find a bonus level to do. Ficus web. Okay, let's go in. Anyway, this one, I had another friend playtesting this game, and it's kind of amusing because the secret stone is right up here, but he was trying to get the area where it is without knowing there was actually something up there, and then he gave up and told me I should put something up there, without realizing that there was already something up there, so that's kind of funny. I just thought I'd mention that because I thought that was kind of funny. Anyway, you can wall jump off of here, you can see it in here, it's pretty obscurely hidden, but I feel like if you just take a minute and look in here, like from a distance, you should be able to find out that that's a ledge you can get up to. I don't know, I don't think it's unfair. Maybe some people have a different idea, but maybe it is unfair. Maybe I need to put a sign somewhere in the level that gives a hint. I don't know. And maybe I will. I don't know. But right now, for the time being, I'm extremely sick of working on this game. So it's not gonna be very soon, probably. Maybe later. Maybe in a few months or something. Okay, anyway, so we completed Le-Wahi, so we're really making our way through this game here. Boop, 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 boop. Okay. This game, it's a long game. I didn't really realize how much I'd actually packed into this game until I started to, like, do full play tests. Anyway, so we have more than plenty of Toa Stones to reach this area here, which is technically Area 3. Actually, I think technically it's Area 4, but that's because of my poor naming scheme when I was building this area originally. So, we've got this big old temple, this big mine entrance here, and we will be not doing it soon-ish. Well, it's technically level 7, so we won't be hitting it yet. We'll be doing level 6 over there first. But before we do either of them, let's do this bonus level. This bonus level is going to teach us a lot of secret abilities. So let's Start cleaning up. Let's, wait. I think I need... I think I can do it from here. I can do it from here. It's fine if I do it from here. Give me this. Okay. Bup, bup, bup. So, this is a pretty cool level that I like. I feel like I didn't design it as well as I should have, because you do kind of have to go up and around and up and around and up and around over and over again, which is sucks. I should have been more careful not to make that the case. But I do like the things it teaches you. I like the look of it. I like all the fog and stuff. I think it's pretty cool. Has a cool atmosphere. And... so I like this level. I like the things it teaches you. I think the challenges in this level are fun. I just don't think going up and around and up and around is fun. I think that sucks. I shouldn't have done it. I shouldn't have done it that way. Anyway, I guess I'll get this one, because this one is kind of out of the way. Can I make it back from here? Nah, well, I don't care that much. I'll just silly kick like a professional Mario player. I'll just silly kick up here. Boop, 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 boop. Get me up there. Bop, bop, bop. Okay, anyway. Anyway, let's do the first tutorial. Wall jumps can be difficult, but did you know you can wall jump at angles? There will be occasions when it's necessary to jump at an angle to reach a ledge. Make sure your angle isn't too sharp or you'll slide off. Alright, so we're gonna have to jump in a triangle to reach this one. Just like that. Nice! Okay, so that's that one. Oh, I forgot about this one. This one sucks. I shouldn't have made this one like this. Ah! I didn't mean to fall off. Okay. So yeah, this is what I mean. Now I have to climb up again, and it's kind of stupid that you have to climb up here over and over again, and it's dumb, and I shouldn't have. I don't even think I had it that way in the original plans. I think there was another way up that I intended, but then I realized it would have, like, broken one of the other things, so I cut out the shortcut, and now it's just, I probably should have just found out a better shortcut. Probably. Anyway, tutorial 2. An extremely useful technique is the aerial kick. When in the air, press the B button will kick. This kick will momentarily prevent you from falling. If you pull back, you can fall into openings like the one below. If you're still moving forward, you'll have a little more distance, which is sometimes necessary for reaching faraway platforms. Just make sure you're not moving too fast, otherwise you'll dive instead. Alright, technically this one's possible to reach from the bridge with a long jump too, but it's actually more challenging, I think, than doing it the intended way, so... so... I don't think there's a way to wall jump. I think I cut that out as much as possible, and I think I managed to kill all the wall jump angles, so... so, there's no way to get that one with a wall jump. You gotta either long jump to it, or you got to... aerial kick it. Maybe there's a way to wall jump to it, but if there is, I haven't seen anyone do it, so. So, anyway. Wonk. What are we at? Yeah, just one. Okay. The final tutorial now. The triple jump dive tutorial. Just gonna slide down here and jump. Okay. Die. Alright, what you got to say? With a triple jump dive, you can achieve more height than a long jump and slightly more distance than a normal triple jump. Simply perform a triple jump and press the B button as soon as you do your third jump. Which is a bit of a simplistic explanation. Technically, you can get more distance if you press it slightly after you do the triple jump, but I figured an easily timed triple jump would be sufficient. Anyway, so if you jump from this stone, I don't think you can do it without a dive. I think you can only do it with a triple jump dive. There's probably a way up, but I feel like for beginners, this is plenty. I feel like they're probably not going to be able to reach it without a triple jump dive, which is what I want, because I need them to learn the triple jump dive, because it's going to make the game much easier if they can figure this out. Alright. Anyway, so that's the tutorials, and now I gotta go up and around and up and around again. So, this is what I mean. I shouldn't have built this level like this, but it's too late now, and I'm sick of working on the game, so I'm not redesigning the whole level. Anyway. Wah! Ba, boo. Okay, let's get this Toa Stone. And... oh, wow, I still have a little bit of time. Well, should I jump into the next level briefly? Maybe we do one... what is the next one? What is the first one? So that was the secret mountainside, which is the second of the Mata Nui third of the Mata Nui secrets level. Yeah, because the river was the second one. Anyway, time for you to die. Stupid scorpion. Okay, so we'll just head in here, and I guess we'll do the first one. The watchtower. Okay, this is an easy one, so let's do it. Look at all these Koli balls. Look at all these Koli balls around. Die! Okay. Welcome to Po-Koro. It looks like some of the local Mahi have escaped. Be careful, they can get a bit pushy. Wouldn't want to get pushed into the quicksand by a Mahi. Maha. Whichever you prefer. Duh! Careful. Careful. Anyway, we're gonna make our way right up this side and up to the watchtower, which is right up there. This is a reference to the Mata Nui Online Game and the Borok animations which followed. This is a reference to the Mata Nui Online Game. Die! This is mine! You cannot have it! No! Okay, it's gone. Anyway, so you're not probably gonna be able to reach this without learning how to triple jump normally. There's a triple jump tutorial in this level, so. Boink! Mine! Anyway, I think I'm gonna call it here. Next episode, we shall continue with the Deserts of Po-Koro. What did I call it? What the heck did I call it? Deserts of Po-Koro. Anyway, hope you guys have enjoyed. From Super Stupidy, it is goodbye for now. Goodbye.